Sven, he's here for 15 months, working his online business that is growing tremendously each and every day. It's amazing to see. And Ronan is also known as the spiritual father of many partners in Opulence Global. And without going any more further, please welcome Ronan Trifon to the call.
Hello, hello, hello. Can you hear me?
Loud and clear.
Thank you very, very much for an amazing hosting, introductory, and edification. I love your fairy earrings and fairy necklace and your fairy ring. You're all shiny. You're looking really good. And obviously, I must say, first of all, before everything, hello to the person that made it even happen for me to be able to be here with you today, because I can see that my mom, Linda Trifon, and I saw my father there also behind her for a second. So this is a very, how can I say, more nerving than usual, you know. I was requested, and I'm very humbled to the mission by the owner of our incredible company to do this leadership cocktail call. And what is the true purpose of this call? Today, it's not about training. It's not about a product. It's not about a compensation plan. What it is about, it's important for me that every one of you that is watching today, and I get this feeling as I see the numbers rising, we're probably going to have more than 100 participants today. So my mission is important with big responsibility. And my purpose today is that if you are not yet with us, either as a customer or as a partner promoting for others, my purpose is for you to be inspired enough today, not so much about our company, because what Yulia has given you in two slides is, it's nothing. This company is the opulence of the industry, okay? So we are not here today to measure opulence. We are here to be inspired, because for me, each and every one of you, if you believe in yourself more today, if you listen to my life story, and you will turn around at the end of the call and say, you know what, if this crazy person did it, maybe I should take that first step. Maybe it's time for me to give a real chance for myself to not be dependent for the first time in my life and control my own financial outcomes. The next thing for me that is very important is for people that are already customers with us to maybe take the next step, and not only for financial reason, purely because you're already experiencing our amazing tool raw material, you're experiencing our fascinating safe home revolution, and you already know that it is responsibility more than just making money. It's a moral responsibility to share with humanity every new evolution that we find, right? And if it is evolving as we all evolve, it's our responsibility to let our neighbor, to let my friend, to let my father, my mother, everyone that I know, to come to them and say, hey, stop using this particular toothpaste with fluorides, with poison. No, there is a new evolution, a new technology. Try this. So my real hope is that today some of our customers on this call will actually say, you know what, that's a good reason to promote. Yes, maybe I'll get very nicely paid for it, but I have a purpose. So I really want the customers to be able to maybe be partners, and for all our partners, our new partners, to get really inspired today by my very crazy life story that I will share with you. And I think you'd be the first one to ever really hear the whole story. I needed to get to, by the way, next month I'm going to be 54. So I needed 5.5 decades to overcome my ego, to stop trying to impress everyone on my life, to stop showing them only my greatness. Today I want to show you actually the other side, because I want you all to understand that this industry, free enterprise, is designed for each and every one of us to do what we want to do with it for our life. So for our young partners, I wish to you to be inspired today to go to the next step which is to upgrade your shop to the most profitable shop, a lifestyle advisor. And for all the lifestyle advisors, I want you to get off this call committing yourself to going LD1 and LD2, which basically means this purpose of the call today is for all of us to identify where we are and take the next step. Because the owner of this company has taught me one thing. It's all about the next step, the next, the next, the next, the next, the next. And if you're busy doing that, you are never stopping yourself, hurting yourself by having what I call emotional blockages, because we're not getting the results we want whenever we want it. And now, no, I'm failing. I'm not good. Okay, so this is the real purpose for this call today. And in order to really start explaining to you how the two people that are with us on the call can actually really know who I am, most people that meet me, especially in the last 7 years, they meet already something that has already been through the process, and they look at me and they say, from the side, oh, it's easy for you. You can do it. You can speak this way. We must understand every time we look at any form of success, we must understand that that person has failed many more times than you if he's achieved a higher success level than you. Now, remember, you can't even measure success because success is defined by the individual. Only we can define what is our success line. So today is for each and every one of you, for all forms of success that you want to achieve, understand it starts with us. This character, at least by stories, I can tell you that because I cannot remember that, but through stories, I've started my life when I was in my mother's stomach, what I call my first home. I started it, and pretty much somewhere towards the end, I woke up one day and there was a whole storm like that. And I'm probably sitting there and I'm saying, hey, who gave you a driving license? Because apparently they had an accident when I was in my mom's stomach. And I always laugh and say that was the first time that this thing was hit. Now, I was then born, and it was obvious that I was hit because the first action I took was at the age of about 1 year old, crawling all day long in the garden, eating stones. Not very common human behavior, but I guess that's what happened from that accident. The next thing, I really started to do things for myself. So I went upside down on the playing ground. Instead of going down the slide, I decided now I'll go against the stream. I climb up the slide and I tried to go with my head down the stairs, ended up falling into a stone with a thing like this stuck in my head. And of course, once again, in a hospital, I reckon that's the second time. They say there was a before that when I was jumping at my dad when he came back and he couldn't catch me fast enough, and I just went through with my head to the ground and my brain sort of opened up a little bit. Stories. It turned out that all those effects have basically made me a very strange rebel, I guess, and very young ages drove my mom crazy with the type of, what do you call those baby things that you suck on? Dummies, I think they call them dummies. So I only wanted to have one type of dummy. And of course, now mom and dad, without really asking me, decide to leave Australia where I was born in Melbourne and take me over to Israel. No one ever asked me, just so you'll know. As I was on the cruise from Australia to Israel for the first time, it turned out that I had a fascination with the fish and I started to throw all those dummies and eventually ran out of the only dummies that I'm willing to take. So I guess for me, always learning the next thing was always through a challenge. The only way I could actually learn to stop being a spoiled rat that only wants this dummy, I guess, was to throw them, not to have any of them anymore. And then I've learned how to not use dummies. When you really think about that, we will meet this same action with the dummies, remember it. We'll meet it a few more times through my life because I believe that I was born three times. I believe I was born once when I was really born, twice when I was about 21, 22, and three when I was 40 years of age. Anyway, On that cruise, I've also shown a lot of curiosity, and I found an electricity socket and put my finger in it, threw me to the other side of the room. I was very excited about that. So I did it about 3 or 4 times, according to the stories. Raised all the way, really, till even first year of school, which was supposed to be the change, you know, we sort of evolve a little bit. First, before the first year of school, I think my father was already getting used to the idea that he's coming home from work, and there's usually a line of neighbors to complain about something Ronin did. It's irrelevant if I took all my mother's makeup and convinced a friend of mine to paint the building. It's, I was a bit of a crazy soul. And obviously, today, I know that I was not so much designed for academic studies or for the normal routine of schools, because from the first day of school, you know, the day before you get the bags, you get all excited, you put the first books and stuff, and you go to school. Most kids actually end up at the schoolroom. For me, 5 minutes before the bell rang for the first class of the first year of my life in school, a friend of mine jumped on my back and I turned down to drop him and he opened his head. So I spent my first day of school, most of it, at the principal's office. It didn't really change much over the years. I really, all the way, I think till the age of about 14, identified that I better start figuring out something else on top of that school thing, because I am surrounded with a family of brilliant minds. Brilliant minds. My father, an aerospace engineer. My mother, the number one expert in the world for incoming tourism to Israel, bringing so much. But I'm not here today to tell you about the people that I adore so much. I'm here to tell you about this character that by the age of 12, if you ask my father, there probably already must have been thoughts like he will either end up in prison or he will end up in trouble, or could not cannot fit with the system. Never really been a good team player in those ages. And of course, then they sent me, they didn't ask you, they sent you to an army, and me and an army again, doesn't work. It's against my soul, it's against everything. And it is funny because I remember that about, I was very, very lucky because both my parents had a very, we're talking now the 70s, in the 70s, people did not travel much. And I was very, very lucky. Both my parents had traveling jobs. And I've seen the world from a very young age. I think almost every third or second year, I was in England at my mum's family side with my grandmother in Bournemouth, with the family in Leeds. I remember that by the age of 13, we already did coast-to-coast trip. My sister, both my parents, all United States. By the age of 14, I've already done Palma de Mallorca. By the age of 15, I think I was already being taken to my first ski experience, snow ski experience in Seafield, Austria. And I remember the first time in my life, I have learned one thing that I want you all to learn when we are talking about success. The first place I understood obsession was actually on that ski trip, because I went on those things and the first day was so much fun and they put you in this school. And I remember that I was fanatic. Even after the chairlifts have stopped, I used to take the skis on my back and climb up a hill and learn and practice. Eventually, we were supposed to go, I think, for about 10 days or 2 weeks, and we extended for an extra day because I insisted that I want to go into this competition of the school. And it's amazing when people ask me, is obsession a good thing or not? I said, like everything in life, it's a matter of scale. But if you're obsessed with something, it means you can't stop thinking about it. It means it doesn't feel hard. It means you're constantly jumping out of bed for the first opportunity that you have to do it, right? So obsessiveness to a certain level with anything you want to succeed in, I believe, is a good thing, right? Again, not go crazy, but have a limit of obsession. Have passion inside you. That is the only thing you can focus on, not because of just income or yourself. Have something in your life that gives you passion because you're literally feeling like you're evolving, you're becoming a better human being and better for others. So all those things in my life, and me starting to work at the age of 14, making pancakes, and after that doing delivering videos and learning the world of money a little bit. Those have brought me to a place that my life was really, really good, intensive, full of action. And after, I got into the army and left the army at the same rank. I got into the army. I think I'm the only soldier that did that, by the way. And then I went and worked in Club Med. Club Mediterranea is 119 clubs around the world that you basically go as an entertainment team. You teach sport in the day. You perform on stages at night. That few years have given me a lot of new skills. And through that world, I went into the world of entertainment through my father teaching me how to mix cocktails. And then a movie called Cocktail came out with Tom Cruise. And once again, obsessiveness, I cannot think of anything else. I decided to become the best barman in the world. And all of the things I've noticed, all the things I was slightly obsessed with are actually the things I've done the best, advanced very fast in. Eventually, I got to a point when I came back from Club Med that something happened inside me, and I start measuring, instead of measuring myself through my eyes, I've measured them through the eyes of the people I love the most, the people that I admire, people that have achieved so much, has dedicated so much, and I felt that I was the most selfish person in the world. For some reason, I totally felt like a failure, and I thought that the more fun I'm having in my life, the worse I am for my family, for my environment. And one day I broke, and I actually decided I'm going to release the world from this horrible pain called ruin. And I went and took every possible tablet I could. When I woke up in intensive care the next day, I understand I was reborn for the second time. Because I understood one thing. I need to understand who I am without the environment that I had around me that has not their fault, my fault. I looked at myself as a failure. And I looked at my father then, I think at that time, and I said, listen, I need a ticket to Australia. I need a few hundred bucks, and I need to go to where I was born. And met me with a smile, and that's exactly what happened. And then at 1990, I flew to Australia for the first time to the place that I was born. Something amazing happened there. Nobody knew me. I had no history. I was born again for the first time, which means I had a clean slate. And I have evolved into a completely different character because of two wonderful things that happened. One, I've went through my hospitality, worked in very interesting jobs, but eventually had enough of the alcohol, the partying, and decided that I need to change a career. I opened the newspaper. I saw this ad, only monkeys work for peanuts. I said, what is this ad? Only monkeys work for peanuts. I went. Eventually, it ended up being Encyclopedia Britannica. Now, I want you all to understand, the only sales experience I've ever had in my life was at the age of 16, a friend came and convinced me to try and sell those security doors. In Israel, it was. And they gave me this bag, and they told me, go and knock on the door. And I went and knocked on the door. Before they opened, I was already not there. That was it. That was my sales experience, not a very good one. And when I arrived at Britannica, I have discovered a new skill. Why? Because I guess it was my personality that never really thought that I could, that made it very humbling for the people. I guess for the first time, I realized that where most people might sell encyclopedias, I was really trying to understand how are the parents seeing the kids and trying to give them a solution for a challenge instead of just selling a book. And I think that that has taught me from a young age that it's always better to be a consultant than a salesperson. Now, what does it mean? A salesperson always wants to move something from here to there. A consultant always really interested in who you are, what are your challenges, and if they can have a solution for one of your challenges, they will offer it. It will usually be accepted very, very warmly. Basically, through the line of Britannica, I have met a family with 7 kids, messy house, and after they bought an encyclopedia, which surprised me, they didn't seem to have the $3,800 or whatever it was in Australia then for an encyclopedia like Britannica. And I was surprised. And I asked them, what are you doing? And they were the first ones that came down and sat with me and start making circles and showing me and telling me about this idea of someone sitting in the middle between a manufacturer and an end user, and they can bring some partners. I didn't understand much at that time. It looked cool. Never seen anything like that. He told me this name of a company I've never heard, Amway. Turns out later the whole world already knew about it. I did not know about it, but anyway, so that was my first touch of the world of social, of network marketing. And the funny thing is I was earning so much money in Britannica that I never even looked at this industry for financial. Never did. Actually, it was the social aspect. But what really grabbed me is that they had something called Book of the Month and Tape of the Week in Amway. Now, because I was a part of a community, for the first time, this brain decided he's going to start reading and actually listening. My mom's here, she knows I'm telling you guys the exact truth. Those 5 years of Amway has brought so much university into this brain in the world of self-awareness, know who you are, and self-development, which I have started to totally evolve as a human being. For the first time in my life, I started to actually see some of my action as a younger as not so bad. I started to learn everything I could, everything that I could. If it was how to win friends and influence people and Napoleon Hill and Rich Dad Poor Dad, then I started to hit them. And it is amazing how much of a university we can go through. By the time that the internet came out for the first time, obviously Encyclopedia Britannica was totally destroyed. I needed a new job, a new idea. What am I going to do with my life now? And I tried many things. I went to work in radio to sell advertising space, and then I went and worked in timeshare. And after that, eventually, I decided to go and do some studies because I've already had a job waiting in this world called IT, information technology, something with computers or something. I had no idea. Now, guys, let me explain to you. We're talking 1997, okay, 1997. This is 2 years after Windows came with Windows 95. So it was the beginning of the IT boom. The IT bubble meant everybody threw money at you, and you can spend it completely irresponsible because whatever you're going to do, it's all a game of shares and investors. And I was just lucky, right? I'm not academically certified. As I told you, I hardly did school, okay? Everything I was self-taught, and the same happened in this industry. It took me into an incredible line of life because the first job that I found in 1998 was a VP of sales and marketing for a company that had 140 people with 4 divisions. And guys, I never done anything in that. And like everything else, like the ski, like everything else, I just jumped in there and I started to do, took action, had no idea, but was obsessed. I took action, made many mistakes, but because I've made enough mistakes, I also got the results. I also had the 10 sales in the first 10 months for the CEO of Microsoft Israel to take me from that company and bring me to Microsoft. And I've done enough there to be able to be taken by a French company and become the Southeast Asia manager for this company in Sydney, Australia. So I had a really crazy life. Why am I telling you that? Because all of this time, I have lived for the first time the world of what we call the world of the rich. It wasn't my money. When you are selling tens of million dollar contracts, you also receive about $70,000 a month spending money to achieve that. So now I'm sleeping in $2,000 a night, $3,000 a night suites, and I'm playing at the big game. And at the same time, remember, this world of network marketing was always edging at my life.
You are muted.
How did I become muted?
I don't know. It happens today a lot.
Where did I stop? Where did everybody stop hearing me? Ah, we are fast. That's a perfect opportunity to drink. And I have to keep it on the 30 minutes line. So I think I have about 10 minutes, right?
Something like that. Everybody, welcome to take a sip of your drinks if you still did not run.
We are having a cocktail. This is a casual call. Anyway, my mom was bringing me, kept me in the world of network marketing because she had this incredible product at the time with another company. And I started to launch that business in Australia. And we brought about 800 people or so. And then I've learned my next lesson in network marketing, okay? Startups are dangerous. Not necessarily what you build might sustain, right? Usually startups that the manufacturer is not actually the owner of the network itself. So there's an investor, now there's shareholders, those are dangerous, right? Because they can be short-lived. It was short-lived. And from there, my sister decided to ask me to come again into this industry with another company called Agile. And at that time, I had enough. I was flying very high. I was getting to salaries of almost 200 a year. You know, I was making money. It wasn't for me. How can I say it? I didn't have time for that hobby at that years. And she even sent me to this meeting in Australia. I went. I was sick. I told her thank you, but no thank you. And she was patient enough until I got to Israel to visit my family, right? And then she hooked me on this come to sushi night, come to some something night. And anyway, there's a whole panel of those people in this company new, and they wanted me to join them. And even then I said, no, I'll work with you. I'll share with you what I've learned in the last two companies, but I'm not interested. And it's funny, by the time that I got back to Australia, there were a few people that really wanted to join. And my sister said, look, give me your credit card, da, da, da. So she pulled me back into this industry. And I didn't understand why. I know today why. That's what I'm about to tell you all. But then I didn't know. And I sort of did her a favor. But once again, when I get obsessed, things happen. And I started to do and do and do. And now I'm developing a network in Australia and a network in Israel. And at the same time, my corporate life is going. And now we're coming very close to 2007. Pivotal point. Remember, born in 67, born again when I was about 21. And now we're coming to my third birth. At Agile, I was doing a lot more than what I've done in my last two companies because I was more mature. I've had a bit more experience. So I've even made a bit of more money. But was at that peak of my corporate world life. And then I had a decision to make between becoming VP sales for a cellular company called HTC and stay in Australia, or do I go and take a project for 6 months in Dover, Delaware, and actually leave the corporate world, leave the employment world, and open my own company and take the first contract. And I decided at that time, I had enough of employment. I understood a long time ago I was unemployable. That's why I came into companies, but stayed short, did contracts with them, did the job and went. I was unemployable. I can only work with people that will leave me alone and let me do the job. They'll get very good results. But people that need to also control you, be your boss, I am unemployable. Anyone will tell you that. So I decided to go to the United States. A year before I went to the United States, not many people know this. Not many people, including not my wife and not my parents, not my family, nobody really knew what I did financially in my life. But if you'd met my uncle, you'd understand that most of my life, he was a character that I needed to get to. I needed to beat. I needed to get to his level. Now, he was a very successful, like the third man in one of the more successful insurance companies in Israel. He's doing very well. And I always said, I'm going to make this big hit. I'm going to make this big hit. I'm going to get there. And because through my corporate life, I was involved with very rich people, eventually, not getting too much information out, but eventually I was invited to join this big deal with 14 very, very multi-billion dollar people. And me and another guy, they were very small people. So whatever we have accumulated in life, plus I needed to go and find ways to get loans and not always from the most comfortable bodies. Eventually, this was the thing. That was so clean, real estate things, that it was supposed to set me free, right? For me, and in those days, guys, my ego was here. I was a different person. Everything was led by the wrong things in my life. It was just ego, ego, ego. I go to the United States, 2008. I get a phone call that basically said, everything you've accumulated in your life, everything you worked with, all your secrets, all your stuff is now gone. You're actually starting your day with close to minus 800,000. Two kids and a wife. Nobody knows anything. I have a wonderful, wonderful family. And they, at that time, without knowing, by the way, they have helped me, my ex-wife, my amazing kids, tremendously, something like half a million shekels. But they did not know the length of the depth of the hole of, and at that day, I thought it was the worst day of my life. I thought it was the worst curse of my life. And it turned out to be, a decade and a half later, turned out to be the most magnificent two gifts I've ever received. And that's why I'm saying I was born again. Because for the first time in my life, I had nothing to lose. I had nothing. Nothing, nothing. And when you have nothing, you have no fear. When you have nothing to lose, you have no more fear. But more important than that, I've experienced what we call ego death. Because for the first time, after 40 years, I looked at all humanity as equal to me or below me. For the first time in my life, everyone in humanity was above me and very few were equal to me. When you start to approach humanity from that place, when they don't need any security with you, when they don't need to impress you, when they don't need to protect themselves from you, you start to receive something completely different from humanity. You start to actually see what I've been seeing for the last year, humans as the most beautiful, perfect creation on this planet. Not because of what they have in their bank account, because you give them enough space to show you without being feared for you to judge them, put them down, or give them tools to hurt themselves. This has allowed me to enter a decade that I consider the most beautiful decade ever of my life, ever. Now, remember, at that point, the only thing I had left, I left the world of employment. My business obviously is not in a good place. What is left? And then I look at my whole life and I said, wait a minute, what about this hobby thing? What about this network marketing thing? Don't you think you better give it a real chance, because what you've been doing with this is playing? I was a sun timer, it was a hobby. I only did it when I had time to do it around my life. I only, spoke to this guy in the elevator and that guy there once every 2 weeks. start, I stop, I never really gave it a real shot. I never gave it what I gave my job when I come in the morning, go in the evening. I never gave it dedication. I never gave it a chance. And I realized I never drove this vehicle properly before. I only had a vehicle, but I didn't really drive it. And then at that time, I was with a company called Monavi. And it was the first company I actually took seriously and ended up with a network of 150,000 people. Now, I love the industry of network marketing because it is designed to give the average individual a real chance at generating a secondary income or a first income in some cases. But at least the companies that I have been in the last 25 years, the compensation plan, the way they pay you was very challenging. Only the people that achieved very high ranks, diamonds and above, made serious money. The majority did not. And then when I started to learn compensation plans, I understood that most of the volume that is sold through your organization is basically limited by ranks, by qualifications, by many little things in the fine print that we don't know when we start. How do I know it? Because 7 years ago, I've had a session of Skypes with some incredible people, this guy called Rene Liao, and then another wonderful character called Reza Mezgarlu and Sherry Zhao, and they convinced me to get on a plane and fly 27 hours from Melbourne all the way to Toronto. I've never been to Canada. The only thing I think there's in Canada is snow and grizzly bears. I didn't really think there's people living in a place. That's all I know. The last 7 years, I've been 12 times to Canada, by the way. Just so you know, at least almost a month every time. Love the people, love the country. Way too cold for me in the winter, but you'll always find me there in the summer if this corona thing will go away already. Anyway, I fly in, and for the first time in my life, like a blessing from my creator for me, I meet an owner that is so different to every other owner I've met. All the other owners I've met, if I met them, they were in a room with 30 people giving us a 30-minute spiel and going. This guy is spending 4 days with me. And he's sharing with me that, like me, he was 25 years in network marketing, unlike me, because he's a world champion with 168 medals, wrestler, athlete, eats the world, you know. Unlike me, he created millions in every one of those vehicles. He was a master distributor. But like me, he recognized that many people are not achieving the things we want them to achieve because for him, and that's what grabbed me about Ramin Mezgarlu, he said, I'm much less interested in 10 people making tens of millions. I want many people to bring home a salary with a part-time job, to bring home $1,000 a week, $500 a week. $500 a week in places like half of this world is a lot of money. And then he showed me how he created a compensation plan that actually can make that happen for the average individual to come and make money from his first week. I have never seen this in network marketing ever in my life. And I actually had to choose between this company and another company that flew me that same trip to Arizona. And the chance for me to join that company from Arizona was much higher. Why? Because it's two Israeli owners that have invited me and celebrated and right. I chose the winner. I chose the wrestler. I chose this person that has become a self-made millionaire by the age of 25. I chose the person that I believed will never sell me out, not to shareholders, not to investors, because he doesn't have them. And he's the only one that runs the show. And I figured out, even if I can't get along with him on everything, it's better for me to be with someone that will keep that ship going, because his passion about his own creation is much bigger than me. which means he needs this to work because he wants his mind to be shared with the rest of the world that network marketing is for the average person and is possible if you do it right, if you do a good compensation plan, and if you create the highest range of product known to mankind in this industry. Over 1,400 in six different shops, six different industries, and not cheap stuff that is for selling. No, the highest level quality manufacturing on this planet. This is not a startup. 16 years, this body exists and grows. And because Romain told me from day one, something that I really, really like, he said, listen, we are not perfect, but we are constantly evolving. And I promise you, if you stay here long enough, you will see that there is never a month that we do not evolve. We do not learn from our mistakes. I am planning to be here for over 100 years and more because this is going to go to my son. So I became a soldier. Now, to finish this, you all need to understand that it takes time to know some of the things I was talking about today. But Opinions Global, from my point of view, after 32 years in this industry, is truly the first real solution for the average individual on every country in the world. I don't know of any company that promotes and delivers like us to over 202 countries in the world. I don't know any. And I don't know any network marketing or e-commerce platform, electronic shops. I don't know any that can give you so many shops, so many landing pages. I don't know any. So the only thing that I want to pass to all of you before I'll give this back to the host, okay? I want you to realize this. In the last year, I've received so many phone calls from people. They say, what? You're stuck in Thailand? You poor thing. How are you surviving? Now here on the island, we have people that stuck, that have lost their businesses, they lost their jobs, and they're starving. You don't know how stressed people are here. They're stuck. And I'm saying, no, relax, it's all good, man. I'm stuck. But I'm making $2,500 to $5,000 every week. I'm okay. So when you look at my whole life and you compare what is the real thing that gave me the peace I wanted, the desire of traveling the world all the time, the things that I call success for me, it's an evolution of many things. Eventually, I found the perfect one, the best one, Opinions. I found it, but the true measure was me. I could have crawled into a corner in 2008 and become a victim. I had all the right reasons, all the right justifications. I could have crawled into a bottle or take drugs, or I could have done that. Or I could have used the self-development and self-awareness tools that I was accumulating since the age of 20 that reminded me the biggest gift we all receive is that we get to reinvent ourselves every day. And no one will ever tell you, you can do this or cannot do that. No one but yourself. Because the man and the woman that says I can and the man and the woman that says I cannot, they are both right. The second you say you cannot. So I invite you all, stop. Say I can. And do not measure your finger. Every time I come to show people businesses and I tell them, man, they ask me, how should I start? I say, start as a lifestyle advisor if you can afford it, nothing else. Maybe I should start in retail. I say, can you afford an advisor? Yeah, but maybe I should start in retail. Let me tell you this. If you can afford an advisor and you start as a retail, what you are doing is believing you're going to fail and trying to measure how much you're going to lose less. You better keep those $200-$300 for yourself, go to a bar and drink, or give yourself a true chance by understanding the success comes from saying it first. And if you want to start a business, say first, nothing is going to stop me till I achieve what I want. And then it makes a lot more sense to start with the most profitable way instead of putting the toe in the finger and losing so much. I so much wish that each and every one of you that is with us, as I said, we passed the 100 viewers, each and every one of you, please understand, I'm not here to tell you that this vehicle is for you. You are here to measure it and decide that it's for you. And if this is the first thing you ever seen, go to whoever invited you today and go and ask them, show me a 10-minute product overview and show me a one-hour webinar of how the business works, how do you get paid, show me, if you haven't seen it yet. If you have seen it, I hope that today was about you. I hope that today you say to yourself, if I keep saying no to certain things, how will I ever gonna find the one that is for me? How? Yes, I can be skeptical. Yes, I can say, nothing works. No, those are excuses. Jump on board. There are so many people that are doing so well in our company. If you are searching for the financial change, come join us. You will never look back. People that come in here, it's like Hotel California. Once you check in, you never leave. Every one of us, look at us. Rene Liao, 14, 15 years. Reza, I am 7 years. I'm considered young. And if you look at some of my partners, remember, this is not a pyramid. The person on the top does not make more money than the person on the bottom. One of my partners, one of them, 2.5 years, I am here 7 years. She's 2.5 years. She makes double the money than me. She makes $40,000 a month. Do you think I can stop her? No, man, go. So please understand, don't measure yourself according to me or to anyone else on this call. Measure yourself according to yourself and understand if there is a change to be in your life. First, we must change. We must make the call. We must ignore the fears. And I always say to people, and this is where I'll end, you must find the courage to follow your heart, because our instinct is to follow our mind. Everything we know from the day we are born is coming here. This is where the doubt is. This is all the can I do it. This is I am so bad. I'm so, until you try to kill yourself. You're as crazy as me. For each and every one of you, this call can be a defining moment, a pivotal moment, that one day if I'll meet you face to face, if you come give me a hug and tell me, man, it was your call that did it. Even if it's one of you, it was worth every second that I've just been with you. Look no further. If you're looking for a financial, jump on board. And definitely, if you're on this call, you want to use the products for yourself, never mind business. Don't miss out on those two raw materials. This is the biggest finding from nature in the last 17 years, 70 years of humanity. You want to use it and you want to share it, even if you're not interested in money. I'm going to pass the call back to you, Yulia. It's been a pleasure and honor for me to serve each and every one of you and open my life to you and show you it's not just the great people that can have a good life. It's also the crazy one that go against the stream. Okay? Join us. Please come and have fun and let's change lives together. Back to you.
Wow, Ronan, what a crazy story. I'm sure that many of the people that already know you, it was the first time for them to hear all of what you've been through. And I'm sure being here on the call together with your mom is very exciting for you. I know how much your family means to you. And for the people who are here for the first time, they had the chance to really hear what people sometimes go through until they found the right place. I think now it's a really good time to let people ask some questions and maybe you can answer them. So any of you who have a question, please raise your hand, type it in the chat room and we can unmute you so you can ask your questions. Please don't be shy. We are here to be open to answer anything that we can.
I would also like to remind, we are not here today for training. So we're not looking for questions on how do I sell or what is the product. We want your questions in regards to your personal doubts, right? If you have any, hey, Ronan, do you believe I can do it? First of all, the answer will be yes. But of course, we might need to take certain actions. We might need to grow. But ask any question. If you know, and it was enough for you, Just go back to whoever brought you and take your next step, whatever it will be, right? If you've never seen anything, take your next step to go and see a presentation. If you've seen a presentation, they should take your next step, becoming a customer and start protecting yourself and your family from poisons. If you already done that, take the next step, become a partner, help us promote, help us really raise awareness around the planet. And if you are a partner, take the next step and upgrade to a lifestyle advisor. And if you are a lifestyle advisor, take the next step and go to LD1. And if you have questions as to any of these topics, please ask. I am really here to share with you. And you've already noticed I have nothing to hide. So you're going to get everything that I have. And if you don't have questions, then I think we've done the best job I can do, at least. But don't be shy. Unmute yourself. Type. Please, this is the part that I enjoy the most. It's the cocktail. Now everybody gets his drink, chill out, and ask questions about anything you want. As long as it can help you, I'm here.
Maybe I can start with one question for the people who are already involved with us. What is the next step they can take? Do we have any special promotion they can take advantage of? Please share with us.
Well, first of all, the next step is so simple. As I said, if you need to gain more information, your next step is to go to We Invited You and book a Robo Recruiter 1 session or a Robo Recruiter 2 session, which means a Robo Recruiter 1 is really when we invite someone while they're in job or something for a 10-minute lunch break. And in that 10 minutes, we really show them our safe home revolution. We educate them as to what we have that no one in the world has access to, okay, in the direct sales world. Then if you already done that and you understand the product, your next step is to be a customer. Register for free, be a customer, start using it so you can see it is real. And you will see all the things. As I said, it's not a product call, so I don't wanna give you testimonials, but just trust me. This thing is nuts. What we have in our hands is nuts. You want to dig deeper into it. If you already are a customer, your next step is to go online or with the help of whoever invited you and to launch your shop. There are 3 different shops you can take. And with each one of those shops, you're basically getting products. That's what you're really buying for yourself. Product for personal use and product to distribute in your local market, right? So imagine that you come to me and say, I want to run a lemonade stand business, right? And I will tell you, fine, I'm actually a wholesaler of blenders and lemons and sugar, and I have 3 packages for you. You can basically pay $300 and I'll give you a blender and 3 lemons. You can basically pay $700 and I'll give you 2 blenders and 10 lemons, or you can pay $1,800 and I will give you 5 blenders and 200 lemons, right? That is it. So if the 5 blenders and the 200 lemons cost me less than what it would cost me to buy after, I'm getting the best value for my money and enough stock, lemons, sugar, and blenders to be able to start selling on the street on a hot day when people come and go. Now, we are not in the business of selling lemonade. We're in the business of having the most exclusive shopping center online. As I said, 6 different shops. So we are wider. And your next step is to go and take one of those 3 shops, retail, promoter, or advisor. I advise you, if you're going to do a lemonade business, be an advisor, man. Get as much as you can for your money and get paid more, right, for every action you take. So your next step is to take your shop. And then your next step is to work with 5 mentors every day and learn how to take advantage of this car you bought. So basically, we have 1 vehicle, a McLaren, the top vehicle in the world, and we have... You can buy it just as is from the factory, or you can buy it with accessories, with an extra computer, and right? So all I'm saying is, when you buy this McLaren today, You can choose to buy the first model, improved model, or supreme model. And if you buy the supreme model, it is better than the other two models. It pays double, you get more value for your money, but all you have is a car. You still need to learn how to drive it. And that's what happens next is you work with us, five driving instructors that will sit next to you and will show you how to practice for your theoretical learning by reading your prosperity book. And they will teach you how to drive physically with you on the road. When you talk to a prospect for the first time, when you talk to a potential client for the first time, when you have to learn that fashion is on Instagram and actually other health product you want to use this way and promote, you're going to learn how to drive, right? That is your next. So for the people that already have a car with us today, their partners, now I invite you to take the next step, start learning how to drive it. For the people that start driving, take the next step of learning how to drive it better and become LD1, LD2. That is, does that make sense? I like to put scenarios so it's simple.
I think it makes a lot of sense. We have a question here from Steffi Gabrielle. Maybe you want to unmute yourself and ask it live. And if you will not unmute yourself, I will ask your question.
Some people are a little bit shy in the beginning. So if you are shy, type it and Julia can ask for you. And if you're not shy, we would love to see you.
Steffi is asking, do we have limits of how we advertise? Like if I want to use a magazine or Instagram or Facebook or just inviting people.
No, you don't have any limits. The opposite, you'll have support. The only thing we don't do is we don't mix ourselves with what we call lower worlds. Okay, so we do not sell our level of stuff on eBay or Amazon or anywhere that people sell a $5 thing, just the money, you know, that we don't do. But we definitely promote on every form of social media platform. And we will bless you. And if you can teach us, we will learn from you. And we will teach you what we've already learned. So I guess the best way to call, to see us is a family. We are literally a family of private entrepreneurs that are using each other's powers and love and lifting each other in order to get better results. It's better to work in a group than to always be on your own and compete against the rest of the world. I hope that makes sense, Stephanie.
Steffi is writing. She tried to unmute but won't work. Thank you for reading for me. Awesome. And provide the logo for legal purposes. Yes, absolutely. You will have all the tools that you need in your back office that you will receive from the moment you launch your own shop.
And I personally apologize that we were not fast enough to be able to give you the ability to unmute yourself. I can tell you that happens to me sometimes. The job of the hosts are so busy with so many, the text and the unmute and the, so Julia is doing an amazing job. I apologize we weren't quick enough because I do prefer to hear people's voices. I believe text has no soul. It doesn't transfer the intonation, the smiles, right? So any one of you that wants to talk, it's not important if you're not already in our family, please share, ask. And if you have nothing else and you're inspired enough. And
continuous question from the same person. She says, I'm a model. Can I make my own commercial?
I think that's one of the smartest way to be able to leverage upon skills you've already created in your life. So that would be very wise.
Absolutely. Miriam Adam has raised up. Do you want to ask a question, share something with us? Need to unmute yourself, dear.
Can she unmute herself, Julia?
Oh yeah, now it just refusing to unmute. I just want to say thank you very much. It is an inspirational, it's not a question. I just want to echo what Ronan said, that it doesn't matter when you study, it's how you finish it, you know, because look at our amazing sister Ifra Hassan, our brother Mohammed Jam. They just started a couple years ago, you know. I've been in the company for 15 years and I learned, but they took it running, so nobody's holding anybody in this company. You know, that's why we are completely different than any other company. It's up to you. You know, I'm honored. I appreciate our CEO and our senior vice president, what they bring it to us, you know, and I'm honored for all our team members, because they say teamwork make the dream work. I just yesterday graduate my daughter because of this company. I paid the university graduate her master's. You see all the celebration here? Because of this company, staying at home while my daughter graduated. So guys, thank you, Ronan, to be my partner, to help us, to be there for us. When we call her, he's always there. Can you be, guys, 4 o'clock in the morning, we did in the call until 4 a.m. in the morning. He never say no. You know, this guy, I salute you. Thank you, Ronan.
We have here Elizabeth Japal, who has her hands on. Please unmute yourself and ask your question or share whatever you want to share. Elizabeth, are you with us? Maybe she will be with us in a moment. Until then, we have Zahara. Zahara, do you want to unmute yourself and share with us your question, please? I don't know why they struggle to, because they are already unmuted. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're gonna go to the next one. Whenever you can unmute yourself, please let us know. Julius Osale, please unmute yourself and share with us your question.
I see, Yulia, that we also have Rico as a host with us. Maybe he can also help unmute.
Hi.
Ronan, yes, I'm actually the one unmuting all of our guests right now.
So, can you hear me?
I can hear it. I feel like I'm in a pub now. There's a lot of background. Everyone's having a drink.
Yes, Julius, we can hear you, but there's a lot of background noise. If you could find a place where it's a little bit more silent, so we can hear your question.
Well, we can go to another pub for the next cocktail if you think this is too busy, this pub, too noisy. All I'm curious at this stage, before we will let everybody go on, I really want to know if there's anyone that has a question as to your next step. So wherever you are, if you want to ask me, okay, Ronan, I am a customer, I am this, what do you think I should do? If it was not clear, please ask, get on board. I can share the screen and even show you how to find on the back office. I'm here to serve you, to help you to take your next step. Because if you're not moving another step forward, you are doing something that is usually very harmful in business, and that is procrastination. And we don't want to procrastinate, but we don't know how long we have to live. So every moment is vital. Just take the next step, whatever steps you want to take, whichever direction you want to step, don't stay stagnant. Make something different every day. And your life will be different every day. It will give you a purpose to get up in the morning and you don't feel like everything is a routine and nothing is changing. You want to create an incredible life? Don't watch other people's life on Netflix. Create your own. And that's by taking the next step. So if anybody doesn't know what their next step and they want to ask me, ask. If there are no questions, then I think Yulia and Rico, we can pretty much close the call by maybe sharing the current promotion that is running until the 17th of May. And again, I always say to people, this is only if you are in a really challenging economical country. It's only if, you know, things are so financially tight that, you know, you really want to, but you cannot afford to start normally, that is what this promotion is for. Okay, this promotion does not say that it's a better way to start with a promotion lifestyle advisor than a normal lifestyle advisor. A normal lifestyle advisor is the most profitable way and in my opinion, cheapest way to start, because you get enough inventory that you can basically sell it and basically cover your investment, right? So the promo is not designed to give you the best deal. It's designed to give you the best chance. Because if you are not starting because of financial challenges, tomorrow is only going to become tougher. And we want tomorrow to become easier, to be your first step to evolving, right? So because of that, our owner created a promotion that allows you to really start. If you start as a retail and you want to jump to the next shop, which is really everyone want to go to Lifestyle Advisor, today you can pretty much, until the 17th of April, you can pretty much do it for half price, okay? As I said, if you are not financially struggling, I mean like no food, yeah? Don't tell me I need to go to the pub tomorrow, spend $400, but I'm struggling, no. Okay, struggling real. If you're struggling, then this promotion is for you. If you're not struggling, and you can easily afford 1,800 Canadian to start a business, trust me, Advisor Normal, 10 times more profitable than the promo. But the promo is because we have an owner that says, I don't believe in an industry that doesn't give a fair chance to anyone, never mind where they're born, never mind what economy there is in their lifestyle, never mind anything. I want to give every human a fair chance. And for that, the promotion was designed. So I see there's no other questions. I'm going to pass this to Yulia. Thank you, Yulia, for an amazing job. You're looking wonderful. And to Rico from the Philippines, that is one of the core, stable individual that is making this company so much better. He's one of the most professional hosts. He even had time to sit with Yulia before this call to get them practicing. Rico, you are a legend, and I cannot see our company without you. So I'm going to pass both of you the call, finalize it, show the promo, and if there will be any other question, I'm not going anywhere. I'm just passing it on to you. And thank you. And this is personal, so I apologize for everybody. Mom, it has been such an incredible call for me, because I think this is the first call you're actually on Connected to Opulence with me talking. And I just want to thank you so much for making me. Thank you.
That was wonderful, Ronan. And of course, we truly enjoyed all the story. Actually, this is my first time that I've heard your story. By the way, my name is Rico Kila. I'm part of the corporate team here in Opulence Global Philippines. And just before we go, actually, there is a question here coming from, we just want to answer all of the questions that are in the chat box right now. It says here, I'm a retailer, started mid-April. I have a few potential prospects that would like to join. What's my next step to upgrade? And that is exactly what Ronan was talking to you all along. We have a wonderful promotion that is going on right now. And I just want to share with you the screen so that at least you can see this exciting promotion. We call this the pandemic relief promotion. It's basically 50% off on all online shop upgrades. So if you heard the crazy story of Ronan, we have another crazy promotion that is going on right now. And it's just basically when you get started as either a retailer or a lifestyle promoter, you can basically upgrade at 50% off. So in here, for you to become a lifestyle advisor, you need at least 1,500 or up to 1,800, depending on where country are you coming from. But in here, when it comes to the upgrade, you have 50% instead of $1,290, you only need $645, and you get this products with regards to the shopping credits that you will receive. So we have another option, lifestyle promoter to lifestyle advisor. All you need to do is to upgrade for 50% of the cost. And as Ronan has mentioned, once you get to the lifestyle advisor position, then you can maximize the earnings, the income potential when it comes to this business. All right. So anyway, if you have more questions when it comes to this, please feel free to ask your questions right now. And as we still have Ronan on the call, and I just want to stop us sharing my screen here. And all right. So we have Sarah Saeed. All right, we have Sarah Saeed, who is, are you raising your hand, Sarah, before we wrap up this call? All right. So another question here coming from Muna Hassan. Before my prospects join, I am in the middle of gathering the remaining funds to upgrade. What's the best step now? And I think I just answered your question, Muna. And I hope that you do get that. You can basically upgrade 50% off on all online shop upgrades. That's the fastest way for you to become a lifestyle advisor. But if you opt to get and maximize the benefits of the lifestyle advisor shop, the lifestyle advisor shop is still available. That's where you get the maximum profits. But if you have any questions when it comes to the details of that, you can basically ask us here, or better yet, get to the person who invited you so that they can basically explain all of the things that you need to do for you to become promoted. Okay. All right, so we just have a lot of messages here praising and thanking Ronan for that such a wonderful story, such a wonderful call. And I myself have been inspired with your story, Ronan. Again, this is the first time that I've heard about it. And you know what we are offering right here, right now, is an opportunity for you to achieve what we call a change in your life. Whether you want to achieve greater things, whether you want to thrive, especially in this challenging times, you just have an opportunity that can help you with that. And, I would like to pass it back to Yulia, who's been an amazing host for today. And again, thank you so much, Yulia, for, facilitating all of these things. This is my first time actually to see you host. You're so cool, calm, and collected. It doesn't seem like this is your first time doing your hosting thing, but nonetheless, I truly thank you and congratulate you for being such a tremendous host. So back to you, Yulia.
Thank you very much, Rico. And 1 second before I close this call, we have Ayan Yusuf who wanted to ask a question. Please unmute yourself, ask the question, and then we can wrap the call.
Hi, everyone. I really appreciate it. Happy Sunday, everyone. And it's amazing. I really learned a lot, but I want to ask a question. I want to have a one question thought. So I just generate for the business for buying and selling, and I get a lot of customer, and then I open a store and I'm really doing good, but I didn't try the other side. So what are you gonna advise me? Because I'm balancing family. My mom, she's sick. I have a big family, like 7 children, 5 boys, 2 girls. And then, so I say I have to build the customers first. And it's not too bad. Maybe it's not too late. So what advice you can give me to go other side to do video and advertising and get a hold of people? Because now I'm free. My younger daughter, she's 18. So I have a lot of time now. I want to step up and be the best I can be. Thank you.
That is a wonderful question. Today is not actually a training call. So what I will highly recommend is that immediately, Ayan, you go to your My5, you talk to your My5 leaders, including myself if you need, and we can sit in 10, 15 minutes and strategize simple daily activities that you should take, both yourself to achieve your monthly MGRS and both with your current partners, so we can bring new partners and develop your current partners to move them to lifestyle advisors and to move you to LD1 and LD2 and LD3. That is what I recommend. Instead of training you here and today, which is not the purpose of this call, but definitely go to your My5 and let's strategize and show you what to do. Easy. And by the way, don't forget everything that we will tell you already written down in your Opulence Bible, which is the prosperity book. Read it. I know. Remember, before I've learned how to motivate myself to read, reading was a nightmare for me. But I tell you, if you read that prosperity book, if you push yourself over the first 10 pages, you won't stop. And now you are learning how to really professionally control your business. And think of all the people you're going to teach.
Yes. Perfect. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Ayan, for a very important question. We have a last one, and I'm going to wrap the show I promise. Zahara, please ask your question. Zahara, unmute yourself, please.
Yes. Good morning, everyone. Good evening, good afternoon, wherever you are. I want to thank you for your time, Ranan. I have learned a lot today, but I have a question for you. And I don't know if this is for my five, or, but I think this is for you. I'm a mother, and I let my 10-year-old join the company this past Thursday. And she is LA now. So my question is, how can I manage my two accounts since this is my first time MLA? Thank you.
Ronan, unmute yourself.
Sorry. Yep, I got that one. I said definitely, and then I'm saying I'm talking to myself. Definitely a my five question. You have to remember that each and every one of us is an individual, which means not all solutions and answers will suit everyone the same way. Many of us tend to register positions on our children before they're at an age of doing it themselves. And we're doing it obviously to secure them positions, to be able to give them an asset when they do come of age so they can start working it and generating income. But also we must remember that in the terms and condition, a person, in my opinion, needs to be about 14 years of age in order to make a decision. So the parent can basically make a parent decision to take an asset, right? So you can take his lifestyle advisor. But I think, and that's where we need the expertise of either Rico or the corporate, but from my reading of the terms of conditions, I think we are allowed to take that asset, keep it for them. I'm not sure if we're allowed to build it, because I do know none of us can actually operate two positions and be involved financially or gain finance from two different positions. So this is terms and conditions stuff. And I think you should talk both to the company and to your Mind Five, so we can find out what's the best thing to do, right? Because we want to keep things real. We don't want just to register some people on some name or do a lot of the games that have been done in the network industry for so many years, which are illegal. No, we're supposed to be really thankful for the company for even giving us a chance to make money upon their hard work, because they don't need us. They could have gone and marketed themselves, make their own money like any other company. So what they do here, the fact that the company is only taking 30% profit and paying us 70%, that's a remarkable thing for a company to do. And only a person such as Ramin that has enough money, is a multimillionaire, he doesn't need more, and he could have made probably more money if he sold this normally through the normal channels. But because he wants to give the chance to us, the average person, right, he is willing to give us the ability to use his company power to improve our family finance. So we need to be really respectful for that. And we want to do things legally, right? We don't want to just take spots. No, you can, for your family, for my kids. My daughter has a spot. My son has a spot. I never in my life put one person in their personal leg. But they do have, because I've built a long time, they have many, many people, thousands of people in one of their legs. So when they come of age, or when they want to use this business, like Vernisha's daughter at the age of 16, she's now paying for a university and stuff. So when they start, they already have 2/3 of the business built for them, and they just need to build 1/3 because of our unique compensation plan. So yes, you can have a position for your daughter 10 years of age, but unless your daughter is Mozart and she's starting to recruit people herself and do it, which, hey, I don't say it cannot happen, but you should not be building her business for her and making money and your business for you and making money. That, in my opinion, is illegal. I would recommend to consult with the company, because nothing we say can be taken as legal side as the company would tell you. We are independent distributors but we're not employees of the company. So we have the responsibility to protect the company and always tell you, check with the company for sure. But that's the best I can give you as an answer. Rico, you have anything to add or correct me on that?
Well, definitely, Ronin. And this is actually, as what you have said, definitely a my five question. And you know, that's the great thing about the system that we have here in this company, that you don't do this by yourself. You have a company, a team that will support you, teach you, guide you, mentor you, and coach you as you build your business. And you know, that's one thing that I truly appreciate, particularly with this kind of business, that you are not in here just by yourself. You have a team that will support you, especially in times like you need guidance, you need mentoring, you need coaching. We have that system that we call the My Five. And I would encourage you particularly to consult this, because this is basically, they can show you the details, the advantages, disadvantages, the legal terms when it comes to the business. So that's one great system that we also have here, the My Five. You should consult your the one who invited you here. And of course, Ronin, thank you so much for putting that context. And that's actually it makes sense. It makes a lot of sense. And another thing is, you know, if you are here for the first time, we just want to encourage you. Get to the person who invited you here. If you want to know more about the opportunity, there are actually more than 35 online presentations happening in different parts of the world. You can basically learn about all of the opportunity, the product, the compensation plan, the company, get more details so that you can be part of this wonderful opportunity. And yes, and we encourage you to be a part of it. And I believe that there's an upcoming online presentations happening any minute from now. So make sure that you coordinate with the person who invited you here so that you can get to know more about the details of what this opportunity is all about. So anyway, that's all I have to say. And again, going back to you, Yulia, thank you so much. And before I end, I just want to thank Ronin. Ronin, thank you so much for that wonderful call, powerful call indeed. And of course, thank you, Yulia, for such a wonderful hosting for today. And to all of our guests who are in this call, thank you so much. And we appreciate the time that you have given us. And I hope that you get to be a part of this wonderful opportunity, wonderful family here in Uplands Global. So and back to you, Yulia. Thank you so much.
For all the people that are here, remember all those type of questions that you were asking, the best place to ask them is on Saturday corporate training. 2 hours that are specifically designed for you to give the questions, get the answers on everything regarding your business. Thank you. And back to you, Yulia. Thank you, Rico. Thank you, each and every one of you. It's been a lot of fun for me. I hope so for you too. Take care.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ronan. Thank you for sharing your story and answering all the questions. Thank you, Rico, for being such an amazing host for a lot of our calls. And I'm happy I had your support here. So thank you very much. And I do not have much to add. We are way past our time. And we will see you on our next Sunday Leadership Cocktail call to get inspired with another leader that we have. So thank you very much, everyone, for attending the call. Talk with your partners, talk with the people who invited you, get involved, keep moving, enjoy your life.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, to the billion. Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye.